In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, after the solemnity of Christ the King, the kingship of our Lord, and the All Saints' Day yesterday, the crown of glory of Christ in heaven, today we celebrate All Souls' Day. We pray for the holy souls in purgatory, and they too are a crown of glory of Christ, because they are saved, they are spouses of our Lord, though they need a purification to be able to see God face to face. Yesterday, while meditating on the holiness of the Church and the holy people of God, we said that the holiness, the very core of the holiness, is the purity of heart and the love of God above all other things. These holy souls in purgatory need to get there, to get that purity necessary to see God. If we are not pure, we are not able to see God face to face. This is the reality of purgatory. That condition after death, a place, a condition of our soul where we have to go through a purification, which is painful, in order to be ready to see God, to look at Him, to see Him face to face. We believe that in heaven the saints and blessed can see God as He is, but God is infinite purity. In order to be able to stay in His presence, we have to become, in a way, like Him. We are sinful people, of course, but through penance we can amend our lives, we can purify our soul, we can get rid of those imperfections which always stain our sight, our soul, and make us unable to be in God's presence. Purgatory reminds us of the necessity of doing penance while we live on earth. If we are not able to expiate all pains of our sins on earth, we have to be in purgatory, expiating those pains. But according to the saints, purgatory is a place where there is much suffering. It is harder to endure that situation and that condition than expiating sins on earth by our penance and suffering. Let us remember what the Catechism teaches us. When we commit a sin, a mortal sin, we commit something grievous, we offend God. But we can be forgiven as we go to confession. When we get the sacrament of confession, the sacramental absolution, we are forgiven. That pain, eternal pain, has disappeared, is now forgiven. But we have to keep in mind that each sin that we commit has some evil effects on ourselves, on other people around us. Sin is something very bad. It is not only an offense to God and a way to prefer something else to Him, but it is also something causing harm to our lives. Spiritual harm, eternal harm to ourselves and to other people, especially those living around us, those affected by a bad example, by that evil that we commit. Evil is spiritual, and it can be passed on to other people as we fall into his trap. That's why we need to do penance in order to expiate that evil that we have committed, in order to appease God's justice and to try to, instead of putting evil into our relationships, to cleanse that evil we have caused with something good, with something which is according to God's will, his grace. So penance is a way to amend that evil by turning it into good with our suffering, our penance, our sacrifice. Of course, penance requires some sacrifice, but it is a way to fix what we have done wrong. This is purgatory. If we are able to do it now, we are really blessed, and this is a grace. But if you are not able to finish this work, we have to be in purgatory, where these holy souls expiate their pains, these temporal pains caused by their sins. In purgatory there are holy souls, that is, people who die in God's grace. We have to die in God's grace, but we still need that situation, that condition, to cleanse all the temporal pains of our sins. If we get an indulgence for ourselves, or for, especially today, for the holy souls, we let, especially if this indulgence is plenary, we let these holy souls go directly to heaven. This is another beautiful grace coming from God's mercy, the possibility to get an indulgence so that all of our pain, temporal pain, to be expiated is cleansed at once by the infinite love of God. This is the love of our Mother Church too, with her merits, giving us the possibility to expiate immediately, straight away, this temporal pain of our sin. And Mother Church is, of course, able to give us this grace because she is rich of merits by Jesus, Our Lady, and all the saints. So let's also remember today to try to get this plenary indulgence for all holy souls in purgatory. You remember the condition: go to confession, receive Holy Communion, and then visit the cemetery, pray for the holy souls in purgatory, pray for the Holy Father, and say the creed to profess your faith. This is a great act of charity towards the holy souls in purgatory. As we pray for these holy spouses of Jesus, we also ask them to pray for us. They can do very much for us. They can pray and intercede for us, and they are very happy to do so. We pray to them so that they can help us now understand the necessity of purifying our soul, be always in grace, die in grace, and be able one day to see God face to face. May our Blessed Mother Mary, Queen of Purgatory, go today to that place to rescue from there many, many holy souls, especially the Rosary. Don't forget, the Rosary is a beautiful prayer to deliver holy souls from purgatory. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.